Hello and welcome to the Arlo Lab.
My name is Anna and I am your virtual technical assistant. Today we will be going over the comparison of the old and new user interface of the Arlo Secure app. In this guide, we will go over what some of the changes are and where you can find the settings and features in the new Arlo app experience. Let's dive right in. We'll start off with the login. Here, the process has not changed, and in the new app, you use the same login information as in the old app. The first change we can notice is the first page. For the old app, we open directly into the device's page, while in the new app, onto the new dashboard. The dashboard is a customizable page. The customizations are set on the device you are using. The web portal, different phones, or tablets will be able to have their own customizations added. Tap on the plus icon in the top right corner to add widgets from your devices. You can add small or large live stream widgets, and for certain cameras, you can add device features such as a widget to turn the floodlight light on and off. To delete a widget, select the three dots on the top right corner and tap on the minus icon above the widget you want to delete. From the dashboard page, you will also have the option to change modes. In the new app, there are three main modes: Arm Away, Arm Home, and Standby. Check out our routines and automations video to find out more about setting the modes. The new Arlo Secure app also introduces the possibility to add multiple locations, allowing you to fully customize your security for each of them. You will be able to swap between locations from all five main screens accessible with the icons at the bottom of the app. If you want to set up cameras to protect your home and an office, for example, and you would like for the cameras to behave differently on each, you can add a second location by tapping on the profile icon on the top left corner to access settings. Select the plus icon next to Locations and Plans, next name the location, and add an address if you would like. If an address is not selected, you will be able to choose a time zone. With a set address, the time zone is automatically selected. Once you select the address or a time zone, tap on Finish. You can now add devices to the new location. Next, to view your device's recordings, in the old app, you'd go to the Library, while in the new app, we have the Feed. To filter recordings, select the three dots in the top right corner of the new app and select Feed Settings. If you would like to download, delete, add as favorite, or donate a video, swipe left and tap on More. To select multiple videos at once, tap on the three dots in the top right, tap on Select Events, and choose the videos you would like. And finally, if you want to go back to a previous day with recordings, tap on the calendar icon in the top right and select the date you want to see. In the feed, you will also see the mode changes, what time and date they switched, and to what mode. In the next section of the new app, we have Emergency, which is a quick access to activating sirens or the option of calling a friend if you have a secure plan. For Call a Friend, you can add up to three phone numbers. To add a contact, tap on Set Up Now. Next, enter in the name and the phone number, or choose from contacts and tap back. When you tap on Call a Friend, the contact will appear, and you can choose who you would like to call in case of an emergency. To edit the contact, tap on the three dots in the top right corner, and next tap on Call a Friend, and change the existing contact or add more. You will also be able to access Call a Friend by pressing and holding the notification directly from your lock screen. Next, we have the Devices section. Under Devices, similarly to the old app, you will have a list of all your devices. From here, you can easily access the camera's live stream. Tap on the image of the live stream of a camera without pressing play, and you can see the list of recordings from that one camera. Next, you can click the cog icon and you will see the device's settings screen. And the last section we have is routines. Under automation, you can set up automations based on schedules or geofence. Tap on modes to see the three available modes and tap on any one of them to customize to your needs. Check out our routines and automations videos to find out more about setting up automation and editing modes. And last but not least, we will go over granting access. Please note that in order to grant access, users have to be on the same app user experience. This means that new app users and old app users cannot grant access to each other. To send a grant access invite, tap on the profile icon in the top left to access settings. Next, tap on People and tap on the plus icon in the top right. The following steps are exactly the same as in the old app. Enter in the user's credentials, select the devices you would like to share, and send invite. The grant access user will then have to accept the invite from their email inbox. We hope this video answered your questions regarding the new Arlo app experience. Thank you for joining me today, and be sure to check out our other videos regarding the new app.